In this video, I'm gonna show you how to set up a perfectly isometric camera in Blender, something I learned in the past days because recently I needed to draw some isometric concept art for a project. And I'm not very good at drawing, but I know how to move around vertices, so I did a 3D blockout to help myself. I'll keep it simple, using the default cube along some kind of blocky stairs as examples. Just need to add a camera and get to the camera properties panel. If I go to the camera view with the 0 hotkey, it's easy to note the difference between the perspective setting and orthographic, the one we need to select. Now, for a perfect isometric view, we need to configure the camera rotation. First, the Z-axis rotation should be 45 or minus 45 degrees, depending on the side you want your render from. Then, for the X-axis, I have to input 54.7 degrees. It sounds a bit strange, but it works, I suppose due to some mathematical magic. Now, I want to show the complete 3D models on the render, but moving the camera along its local Z-axis won't change anything because we don't have depth perception. To zoom in or zoom out our camera, we have to change the orthographic scale option on the camera properties. Shift X and Y can be used to pan our view, but I prefer to just move the camera. I took a render and brought it to Krita, where I have an isometric grid template ready. As you can see, the renders fit perfectly on the template, allowing me to work with them. Using this to draw over is just an example of something you can do with this approach, but it's also useful to create the classical isometric rooms and dioramas renders that a lot of people enjoy modeling, or also it's a great way to create isometric tiles for game development. And that was all I wanted to explain on this video. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.